In the film Lords of Dogtown, the Pacific Ocean Park Pier serves as a visual motif throughout the film. Set in Venice, California in 1975, this spot serves as a trademark location for the surfers and skaters of the area. If you notice in this scene, the camera is placed under the skateboard, and I think they're placing the focus on the new polyurethane wheels which have just emerged at the time. It's a new style of skateboard wheel that grips the concrete a little better than the traditional wheels they were using before. As the scene progresses, the camera focuses on Jay Adams sliding up the banks, and quickly back to the bystanders showing the expressions on their face as you can clearly see they're surprised at the tricks he's doing with these new polyurethane wheels. And I think the cinematographer really used a great choice of angles here, showing exactly what Jay Adams is doing and then quickly going back to the bystanders to show their expressions. It really makes the viewer feel the same way as the bystanders in the film. In this scene, we're at a skateboard contest, and Skip, the owner of the skate shop, created a team, the Zephyr Boys, and Jay Adams is debuting his first heat, if you will, and the cinematographer uses a similar style here by going from Jay Adams back to the bystanders and then to the judges. The camera angle quickly shifts from Jay Adams' feet to his face to show his expression, and then back to the bystanders and the judges, and it almost gives you a sense of perspective that you are Jay Adams for a moment. You feel what he feels, and then at the same time, you feel what the bystanders feel because the camera angle quickly changes back to them and shows their perspective. Another prominent aspect of the cinematography in this scene would be the color choice. You can see this blonde is wearing a very vibrant dress, as well as the female behind her. And then there's Skip in the back wearing his intricately detailed coat. And then there's Jay Adams with his bleach blonde hair, almost being a symmetry of this blonde who's impressed by his skate tricks. The color choice in this scene really makes you feel like you're in 1975. I really like the use of lighting in this scene. As you can tell, it's filmed at night, but the light from the house serves as a natural ambient light that creates these brilliant warm highlights on the cool color of the car and contrasts well with the shadows in the background. As the scene moves, you can see Stacy getting out of his car talking to his girlfriend, and the cool tones on the street really balance well with the warm highlights bouncing off of the car. As well as Stacy and his girlfriend, they seem to be glowing under the light coming from the house, and Stacy's blonde hair looks almost golden in this light. As the scene progresses, you can see the golden light that was on Stacy and his girlfriend before is really accentuated now as they move a little bit closer to Stacy and his girlfriend as they're laying in the grass. The shadows surrounding them are deepened, but the highlights on them are more prominent, and they really do have this golden glow that's very pleasing to the viewer. As I mentioned before, the Pacific Ocean Park Pier serves as a visual motif throughout this film. As we come back to the pier later in the film, the mood has completely changed. As you can see, Jay and Skip are now closer than they were in the beginning. And there's almost this sense of sadness, if you will. Time takes its toll on everyone, and time definitely took its toll on this pier. There was a fire that left it almost in shambles, so the pier is barely holding on. And this is resembled through Jay Adams barely being able to hold on to his dream of skateboarding.
I mean, thank God, man, because in winter, this place goes off.
We had it all to ourselves.
I also really like the natural light the cinematographer chose to use for this scene. You can see the sunset behind them, or it might be the sunrise, providing a very ambient, nice backdrop for them, and they have these natural tones of light on their skin. It just really has an intimate feeling to this scene.
I just had to pay the rent.
Hey, man, your mama, she has to eat, right? She has to eat.
Skip walks away. Jay Adams feels a relation to Skip as he's a father figure in his life. Jay Adams doesn't have a strong father figure in his life. I want to let the music from this scene actually play because it adds a strong emphasis to the feelings that the cinematographer captured.
Oh man, look at my life. 24 and there's so much more. Live alone. Paradise that makes me think of two. Love lost, such a cost. Give me things that don't get lost, like a coin that won't get tossed, rolling home to you.
See that thing? Yeah, mine's real.
Dang. The use of close-up shots by the cinematographer really amplify the intimacy of this scene as well. As you can see, Jay Adams got a tattoo on his head in honor of his friend Sid, who has brain cancer, who now has a scar on his head. And the cinematographer chooses to zoom in on both of their heads to really show the connection they have as brothers. And the lighting as well, you can see these dark shadows under Sid's eyes. It really exemplifies the despair that he's feeling going through brain cancer and chemotherapy.
It's pretty punk rock, bro. Guys. Let's get him in here.
Oh, yeah.
Cinematically, this is a very powerful scene because in the beginning of the film, Sid didn't have brain cancer and he was able to skate with the boys. And now at the end of the film, his brain cancer has really taken a toll. And so Jay, Tony, and Stacy decide to bring him into the pool for one last skate sesh. And they really treat him as if he's not changed. He's still the same Sid. The cinematographer does a really well job capturing the emotions here as it's a nostalgic feeling and you can tell that there's an overlooming sadness in the air, but despite all that, they have a good time just like they always did. Throughout the film, pools have been a staple for the Z Boys as they revolutionized skateboarding in pools. And as Sid mentioned, this will be the first time they won't have to worry about getting in trouble for it because Sid's dad granted them the use of their pool. The pool serves as another visual motif throughout the film. As you can see Sid sitting on the drain in his wheelchair in the center of the pool, I feel like this was a great choice of angle by the cinematographer to portray Sid as the center character in the scene as well as the story as it comes to a close. He's their friend they've had since the beginning who's dying of brain cancer, and the way the cinematographer chooses to highlight Sid in this scene while the Z-Boys skate around him, it really pulls on your heartstrings because you start to feel for Sid, the boy sitting in the pool in his wheelchair who can't skate like he always did. I feel like this is a great ending scene for the movie. It's not the last scene, but it is one that helps the story come to a close.